everyone, and thank you for joining us today for this exciting Inside Sales event. My name is Heidi Bullock, and I'm the GVP of Marketing here at Marketo. Today, we'll discuss how marketing automation in concert with the right marketing and sales efforts can help you drive more revenue in the most efficient way possible. And I think that's what we all want to do. So today, the topics I'm going to cover will touch on challenges, because we all know this isn't easy, key considerations, and then I'm going to provide some examples where you can use marketing automation and the right practices at each of the business stages for optimal performance. So let's face it, our jobs today are definitely getting harder. I currently run marketing at Marketo, and I have the enterprise, SMB, and customer upsell, cross-sell business, and it's definitely more challenging than I would say 5 or 6 years ago. We have more technologies we have to choose from all the time, and it seems like, in general, we have to do a lot more with less. So let's get to some of these challenges. In general, many of us can relate to this. It seems like you always need more qualified leads and, of course, pipeline. You need to drive more revenue and close deals faster. And in general, it just feels like you're having more added to your plate. I think everyone can relate to that. Number two, I think I touched on this briefly, but all of us feel like we have to do more with less. With added demands, you or your team may feel like you have more programs to build out, and this could include webinars, emails, landing pages. Some of you are looking at account-based marketing, and as many of you know, that is a great, great strategy, but it can also take some time. So how do we really approach that challenge? Number three, and this is a big one, and hopefully we'll make some progress on this today, but you know, marketing and sales alignment. You know, you may have some disconnect with sales if you're in marketing, or vice versa, around maybe definitions, or maybe what your goals are, or maybe even the time in which a certain group should be addressing different things. And that's what we'll talk about today, because you really have to see things in the same way and be on the same page, or things will be very, very challenging. And number four, and this is an important one, ROI and initiatives. So to ensure, whether you're in marketing and sales, that you get the budget you need to hit your goals and also protect what you have, you have to demonstrate and prove the value of what you're doing and show that ROI. And I think this is specifically true with marketing. Sales is a little bit more easy to say you hit your target or you didn't. But you need to be able to answer, you know, what's your top performing channel, your top performing program, how are you doing? So with all that, many of us can start to feel like this. This is the mood, right? It feels overwhelming, and it can feel at times almost impossible. And I personally talk to a lot of marketing and sales executives, and I think, you know, all of us watching this today can really relate to this feeling. But hey, don't worry, we've got this, and that's why you're all on this webinar. We're going to talk about some real practical tips, and my objective with today is actually to make this really, really reasonable and things that you can go back and think about and put in place right away. That's my goal. So let's start today's webinar, really get this going with key considerations. What are some of those fundamentals that are important that we need to be thinking about? And this is regardless of whether you're using marketing automation or not, but I'm going to go through some things that I personally have seen really, really that are critical to getting the business right. And the first one, and this I feel strongly about, is defining your revenue model clearly with stages and SLAs. And what I mean by that is, this may look like a simple funnel to many of you, or a revenue and sales model, but it doesn't really matter if your stages are a little bit different than this. That's okay. The point is, make sure that this is clearly defined. Your marketing and sales teams could both say, yep, we agree, this makes sense. And there's three critical points that I want to make here. And the first one is, make sure that you agree on the definitions and the stages, right? So you and your head of sales or head of marketing should say, this is the definition of an opportunity. We all agree on that. Number two, clear service level agreements. And let me give you an example of what I mean by that. Many of you are familiar with SLAs, and that's really where you say, look, from the past, from marketing to sales, maybe to a BDR and SDR, they have 8 business hours to follow up on an Act Now or an MQL. Whatever that is, make sure that's very clear and documented. And lastly, I think this is important, make sure those incentives are in place. At Marketo, a salesperson determines an opportunity, and that is how I am compensated. And that's really important, because I'm incentivized in the same way that a salesperson is. So I really think getting those incentives right is critical too. So now number two, what do we want to look at? This is important. Do not start with tactics. And I can't get over how many people I still talk to and, you know, you start a conversation, well, let's do this great event or let's do this, you know, amazing partner webinar. Don't do that. Really start with the objective. So in this example I'm showing you, the central region needs to close $2.4 million this quarter. How are we going to get there? We need a total of 9 opportunities in this example. And this is a slide, steal it, feel free. But what I'm showing you is we are basically working back. We're saying, here's the tactic of what we're going to do, sort of the stage in the business that it's applicable for. You know, let's look at the analyst field lunch. It's mid-stage. We think we're going to get 3 ops. The reality is you're probably going to close one of those. So you work back from all these activities and you get to your 9 ops. That is really important. So make sure that you have a work back plan and call people out on that when they just kind of say, hey, let's do this thing. You really want to start with your objective first. Now, number 3 is making sure you're mapping the right strategy to the desired outcome. And this may seem like an obvious thing, but I just kind of want to set people at ease here. You know, we heard a lot about inbound marketing several years ago, and now we're hearing a lot about account-based marketing. Both of these are really not new strategies. I can tell you at Marketo we do both. And I think it's just important not to get too caught up in what seems trendy at the moment, but really, again, think about what are you trying to drive? For our enterprise business, we use a lot of target account-based marketing. We actually are using it in our SMB business as well. But, hey, that doesn't mean we're stopping doing our content marketing or a lot of our inbound strategies as well. So I just think it's really important to keep in mind these are strategies, but be clear about what your goal is. And if you're a company that markets to, you know, 10 top pharmaceutical companies, account-based marketing is probably going to make a lot of sense. You know, if you have a real high volume, low price product and you can convert people easily on your website, inbound's probably good. And I'm just exaggerating the point, but just keep those things in mind. And again, we use both at Marketo. Number 4, and this is, again, something I feel pretty passionately about, and this is measure your programs and your initiatives at different time points. It's not that looking at website traffic or, you know, conversions is wrong. It's just an early stage metric. And this is, you know, another slide. Feel free to just to scrape this. But what I'm showing you is for target accounts, we clearly are articulating what our goal is, what our metrics are, and what we're looking at along the way. Because in most cases, if I'm marketing to a target account, I'm not going to see that pipeline or that meeting probably for several months after our initiatives really take off. So what can I look at from an early stage perspective to know, is this program going well or isn't it? So this is just an example of, you know, it's not one metric is right or another is wrong. It's just some are early, some are mid, and some are late. So keep that in mind. And I think a grid like this is very helpful to use. Now, tip number 5 is be thoughtful about your technology. And we do not want a Frankenstack. And I brought this up earlier. I mean, it's pretty overwhelming with MarTech right now. And even sales technology, there's so much of it. So, you know, what you don't want is a Frankenstack, and that's where you have a set of, you know, siloed tools an organization tries to make work together, but it's just all cobbled and together and it doesn't work effectively. And you really want to think about what are you ultimately trying to do? What can you not live without? For most of us, it's going to be, you know, you have your CRM system, you've got your marketing automation, and then you have some other tools that are very, very critical for getting your business done. And I just think make sure you have a complete view of what your organization needs. Don't just look at marketing. Don't just look at sales. Try to do that together so you make sure that, you know, sales isn't collecting a bunch of duplicate tools that marketing might already have. You really want to be cautious of that. So I encourage teams to get together and discuss, you know, what are you trying to achieve and do you have the right technologies? Now, number 6, this is really, really important. Have a few key metrics and iterate to improve results. And I'm pretty passionate about this, but I think it's important to focus on decisions that improve your marketing or sales. You know, a key part of the planning process is to identify upfront what decisions you need to drive, you know, your company profits, and then build your measurements to capture the right information. And so this means you should not measure things just because they're measurable, but rather because they will guide you towards decisions you need to improve your company profitability. So I'm showing, you know, a 747 dashboard. Most of us sitting in that would not have any idea what to do, but you can look at the dashboard of the Audi and it's pretty clear, you know, what you're looking at. So you just really want to think about what are those key metrics you need to make the right decisions in your business. And I get it. It sounds easier than it is, but if you have the discipline to do it, it makes a big difference. Now, number seven, this is the last tip, and then we'll get into aspects of the funnel. But this is important. There is no I in team, and I tell this to folks all the time. You know, our goal with marketing and sales together is to drive revenue. It's a team sport. So you don't want your marketing team going and saying, hey, you know, we hit our MQL goal, we hit our lead goal, if sales is missing their goal. No one is winning here unless you're hitting that revenue number. And so this is a subtle point about, it's kind of internal education with your team, especially if you're in marketing. Don't claim victory unless you're hitting those pipeline and revenue goals, because again, we're all in this together. So those are kind of the seven tips, some just good framework principles to keep in mind. And so now what we're going to do, we're going to move to section two. And this is really where some nice clean examples of where marketing automation can help drive your business. And this is going to be fun. So the first thing I want to say is, again, regardless of your approach, whether you're using inbound marketing, whether you're using, you know, account-based marketing, number one, you have to hit your business goals. That's just a fact. Number two, marketing and sales have got to be on the same page, and we'll discuss how to do that more effectively. And then really, you need to know what's working or not. These are just three key principles. And so what I'd like to do is I'd like to take a look at a real kind of classic process all of us are thinking about. It's really, you know, attracting people. This is where you're trying to drive awareness, engagement for those new leads or prospects, engaging them, whether that's an individual in a target account or, you know, a set of individuals that you think are going to be buyers, and then you want to close, you want to win the deals. So these are the phases that we're going to talk about, and I'll give you examples for each of them. So at the attract stage, which is a very, very important one, you know, this is a critical thing. You're really trying to drive preference. You're trying to make sure that people are aware of your products and services. So at the end of the day, you're really trying to make sure you're driving people to your website. You want the right buyers, or again, if you're doing target account marketing, you want those right accounts going to your website. This is important. So how do you do that? What are some scalable ways that marketing automation can help? Now, the first one is you really want to think about SEO. You know, again, I mentioned at Marketo, we do tons of target account-based marketing. I still want my target accounts finding me and getting to my website. That is still something I care about. Even though I'm using other tactics to attract them and be very focused, this is real. This is something you have to think about. So what's great is with marketing automation, and again, I'm using Marketo because that's the tool I use, I have ways of very easily optimizing my SEO so I can see what are some keywords I should look at that I may not have thought of. Or it also can recommend some landing page optimizations that I can think about. So really, really important. So again, you're getting more people to find you, and in marketing and sales, that's critical. We need to do that. Now, number two, you get people there. Now, how many of you would send one message, you know, to your entire database? You wouldn't. That would be like me saying, hey, everyone, come to my house for a party. You would think that was weird unless you know me. So let's think about the website. How can we have a personalized and rich experience for people that are either anonymous or known? You know, again, maybe you're only marketing to a small number of defined companies, but guess what? You're probably trying to dive deeper into those businesses, and there's still going to be people that are not known, but they want a welcoming message when you come to your website. So in, you know, when you use marketing automation, specifically Marketo, you can use web personalization, and that is the ability to have a personalized message based on unknown or known visitors. And it can be from a different vertical. It could be across many different ways that you can segment. What I'm showing you here is actually for target accounts. Maybe we're marketing. This is an Apprenda example, a customer. And here, if they're UPS or Barclays, I can have a very nice targeted landing page. So you can get very creative here, and it's great whether you're, again, using account-based marketing or not. That personalization is very important. And also, you even assuming you do that, you might not convert everyone the first shot. You really want to make sure you're targeting the right buyer, right account. And you can use, you know, Marketo to be very targeted and specific if you're using retargeting. So here is a simple example my team ran. We were marketing to folks that were in the healthcare industry. We wanted them to be a marketing manager, a specific title, with a lead score of 60 and above. And we only targeted those individuals. And this is just, you're actually seeing ads that are positioned on Forbes, but look at the results we were able to drive. So if your marketing team is doing retargeting, let's do it in a way that's focused and is going to hit the right people. So that's a great thing you want to do. You also want the ability to test and optimize early. And what I like is, you know, testing to me is kind of like brushing your teeth. Many of you know you need to do it. You might not do it as much as you should, but you should. And the cool thing is when you do use marketing automation, you can do this at scale. This isn't killing anyone. You can actually do this in a very easy way. And the simple example of what I'm showing you here is just a subject line test. And by testing and going with the better open rate, look what I'm able to do and the results I'm able to drive over a year's period of time. So say, you know, I see an increase of about 5%. I can get a significant better open rate there. Maybe that adds up to, you know, significantly more additional opens over the year if I'm taking that subject line, and I'm going to have a lot more additional opens. And that's critical. That is what you want. So this is very, very simple and easy to do. So you want to make sure you're testing. So now, those are just some simple tips. Of course, that's not everything I'd like to get into, but those are some key things at the early attract stage. Now, engage is really where you've got people in your database. These can be individuals or accounts. So what can we do to make sure that we're progressing them and increasing that velocity? Now, the first thing, and I think most of you listening know this, is, you know, no person that you're marketing to today is just on one channel. They're just not. Many of you today, you know, you look at your phone, you look at your computer when you get home. We're all on multiple channels. So guess what? You need to market that way. And what I love about marketing automation is you can do this in a scalable way. I can set up one program, look at different channels, and I can have the same message and make sure it's engaging and relevant and feels very personal. So that's an important thing you want to be able to do. I also, this is very cool, I can keep sales in the loop along the way. So here is just an example of what a program rollout that I would do for a target account. Now, each of these stages with marketing automation, I can have an alert sent to a rep. I can let them know when somebody takes a key action, and then we can make sure that even when the follow-up calls are done at the end of this, that's all logged. So I have that in Marketo and Salesforce, and then I know, great, I can see what's working, where I've had connects, and where I need to, you know, continue to optimize the program. So this is critical. It really helps marketing and sales have more of a dialogue throughout the process rather than just, hey, sales, here's what we've been able to generate, which I like. Here I'm just showing a very simple screenshot of, again, what I'm talking about. This is really where I'm showing how our SDRs can prioritize some ABM follow-up. So we're just looking to the far right-hand side. These are our enterprise target accounts. These are some top 20s, and I can actually just show some of the activity that's been happening. So this is a very simple and easy thing for them to be able to look at, and this can be done on a mobile phone, which is really, really great. Another thing that I think is critical, and this is very important if you're in marketing, all of us, and I mentioned this earlier, are doing so many marketing programs. How do you do this at scale? And hey, if I could have one pitch for marketing automation across the board, it's that ability to scale. That is why I bought marketing automation at my last company. And here what I'm just showing is how simple it is to just think of this as copy and paste just like you would in Word. Now, if you're not using marketing automation and you're maybe using another technology, look at a simple webinar program. To set this up, and this is a reality, everyone, and if you're in sales looking at this, this is the work that goes into it. It's a lot. This could take you 2 hours. With, you know, using Marketo and our cloning capability, you break that down into about 3 minutes. So what's cool is you have the ability to do a lot more in less time, and you're just efficient. You can use your brains on other things that can drive the business. And lastly, what I want to touch on here is that ability to personalize at scale. All of us have heard, you know, it's so important to be personal and that one-to-one interaction. All of you listening today get that. It's not like that's revolutionary. But you could be saying, great, but how do you do that? Now, when you use marketing automation, here what I'm just showing is dynamic content. I might create one email, but I have the ability to market. I'm just showing here I'm marketing a hotel, but I'm showing just different segments based on age. I'm showing kind of a 20-year-old kind of segment. I'm showing a family segment, and then I'm showing a senior segment with the luxury vacations. I'm just popping in a different image. If you're in B2B, this could just be flipping out a case study, one that's great for enterprise or one that's great for SMB. And there's a lot of other ways you can personalize based on even, we have triggers, and that's, think of that as if somebody downloads a white paper, I can have an alert sent to sales. If X, then Y. And that ability to be real-time and personal is huge. And again, I wish I could talk about this for 20 more minutes, but there's a lot of great things you can do on the personalization side. So lastly, with the time we have left, I want to talk about closing. And this is really important. And how can we all do this better together as a marketing and sales organization, and how can technology help us? Because this is what we really care about. Now, to me, you know, sales and marketing alignment, you need to be collaborating closely with sales. We showed some examples there of how marketing automation can kind of give those alerts, and sales never even has to get into marketing automation. They can see, you know, what conversations or activities are having taking place right within your CRM system. I think it's important to develop a plan for both sales and marketing to execute on. I can't stress that enough. I mean, marketing automation is not going to solve that, but you need to sit down together as a team and make sure that you have the same view of that plan. We talked a little bit about service level agreements and having those agreed upon times for follow-up, coordinated outreach, and we'll get into some examples coming up here. And then I think it's really important, regardless on, you know, the tools you're using, get feedback. I really think it's important, and again, this isn't a technology piece. This is you as a marketing team or sales team opening up that level of communication and getting feedback, because that's the only way we all get better, which I just think is important. So now, kind of on the technology side to close, you know, what can marketing automation do? Now, number one, I think this is a good one. It's lead scoring. And lead scoring, for those of you who are not familiar with it, it's just a methodology, simple methodology to rank leads to determine their sales readiness. So that way, you know, think of, you know, your sales team, and if you're in sales, you want the ripe oranges. That's what you want. You don't want the trees without fruit. You don't want the seeds. And that is marketing's job. Our job is to get you those ripe oranges. And a lead scoring is a great, great way to do that. So we have a good sense of, hey, this is a good lead. It's just not ready yet. So we're making sure to get the right folks over to the sales team. And so lead scoring, you can look at demographics. So as an example, is this a VP of marketing? They have a high likelihood to purchase. Great, we're going to score them higher. And behavior, and something that Marketo is doing, we're also looking at account. So we look at somebody's, you know, basically their demographics. We look at, are they an account that we feel we can sell into? And then we look at behavior, those three facets. So a really powerful, powerful way to do that. Now, you can connect your CRM with marketing automation, and this is great. This is what the sales team is going to care about. You can prioritize those leads for sales through lead scoring, and we have some great, easy ways to do that. You pass all the marketing data over seamlessly. So, again, if you're in sales, you don't need to get into marketing automation or Marketo. Forget it. You just stay within your CRM, and you get what you need there. As a marketer, I can see how sales is following up, which is important. And then I can also give my sales team the right insight and tools they need for success, which is really important, and that's my job to make that seamless and easy. And here I'm just showing, this is our Sales Insight tool. This is just native right in Salesforce, and I can get all the information I need on, you know, who I should be following up with, what was their last relevant activity. So I'll just show here. So I can actually see, you know, look, before I call somebody, if I'm an SDR or a BDR, what did this individual do? This is in my target account. I need to know, did they go to that field event? Did they look at that direct mail piece? It's all here. So that way, you know, your team, if you have SDRs or BDRs, can have the right conversation. Now, we talked about SLAs a little bit, and that's those service level agreements. And what I like about Marketo is this can be a lot more operationalized, because it actually can be built into the system. So you can say, look, if a lead has not been followed up, or an MQL, whatever your terminology is, alerts can be sent out. And this is, you know, up to the company, but I like this because I think, again, it makes everybody really accountable. So, you know, when a lead becomes a lead, if after the first day an SDR hasn't touched it, they get a nice friendly reminder, and you can see over time they get a little less friendly. And, again, that's up to you, but you can do that. So Marketo, you know, we have times for everything. Our SLAs are, you know, maybe we have different terms, but in MQL it's 12 hours. We have, you know, an act now, which is a very immediate action, and they have 8 business hours to follow up. So what's great is, again, these alerts can be sent out if that's not happening. Now, this, I think, is just, again, one of those important things. You really want to think about sales and marketing as one team. And this, again, technology is not going to solve this. This is how you run your business. And I have found these things to work. Meet frequently. I love my sales team. I love my SDR team. And I deeply mean that. I care, and I get that it's a hard job. So I'm not going to sit in on the marketing floor and say, great, I went to an event and got all these leads. Never, never, never. I'm going to talk to them and see what's working. I'm going to shadow sales calls. Why? Because I can see for real what the problems are. I'm not going to go sit somewhere and not know what my sales team is faced with. So I encourage, if you're marketing, do that. Sit in calls, understand what those challenges are. And again, it's a two-way street. Everyone needs that feedback so we can get better. So again, just some key principles. And then lastly, we had talked about, I'm going to end here on ROI. And this is an area that I'm very passionate about because I look at my job in marketing, and this is important if you're in marketing or sales, my job is almost like an investment maker. Granted, I'm paid less than an investment maker, too bad. But it is my job. I'm given a marketing budget. I need to get the best return possible. I'm not married to any channel or any program. I take emotion out of it. What I do look at is what is working and driving the business. Now, with marketing automation, this is what I'm looking at. This is cool. I can look at my channels, what investment I made in these particular channels. Here, what you're looking at, I'm looking at the first touch, the opportunities that were created, and then we use a metric. It's our pipeline ratio. So we look at the pipeline created for really the investment I made in that particular program or channel. And so you can see that. And I can also look at days to opportunity. This is cool. I can get to really understand velocity. And as an example, I know that content syndication or live events, they take more time. Pay per click on the other side, it moves a little faster. And that's good as a marketer for me to know that, because then I can tell my sales team, yeah, we had a great event, but that might take a little longer to see that return. And so you could say, Heidi, why do I care? This is why you care. I want to have a good understanding of the program and really understanding what is effective at acquiring the right leads, so my acquisition channels. And then I want to understand, what are my good programs for accelerating these leads and, folks in target accounts through my funnel. So maybe I do a lot of field events for target accounts. They're not probably going to get first touch because that wasn't the first touch point of bringing somebody into my marketing and sales funnel, but they're great for deal acceleration. And as a marketer, you need to know what is good at doing what. Very important. Here I'm just showing you an example for target accounts. This is just a simple example of how I would look at one particular account, understanding, how many people have I been able to build out in that account? What's the pipeline that I currently have created? Are the programs that I'm sending to this target account, are they working or are they not working? You need to be able to answer those things. And again, for those of you who've done target account-based marketing for a while, yeah, you could get to that before, but not in a scalable way. And I love that technology is catching up. And Marketo has a good account-based marketing solution. Definitely check it out. There's other really great technologies, too, that can make this easier for all of us. So, again, if you're doing that, make sure to look at the right technologies. And here I'm also just saying, how am I doing in target accounts across the board? So this is in Marketo. I'm basically saying, here's my named account. What are the number of opportunities I've created in that account? What are the average days to close? And what revenue have I generated? I mean, how many of you want to be able to answer that question? That's pretty cool to be able to do that. So, I'm going to end on these key points, and I really hope this has been helpful. I wanted to go over again the challenges we all see that I think all of you can relate to, some good fundamental framework principles that, again, even if you're not using marketing automation, those are things you can think about. And then think about how technology, again, not just marketing automation, but any tools can help you and make your business more effective. They shouldn't be slowing you down. They should actually be helping you. So we talked about, growing your top of funnel and increasing conversion, that early attract phase. And think about, being personal. And again, marketing automation can help you do that in a scalable way. You want to think about, once you have people in your database, marketing automation helps you have more of a conversation. It's kind of, again, think about my point of, if somebody does X, then you can do Y. And it's a lot more real time than if you're just using an email service provider and just blasting people. Number three, I'm a huge fan of this. This is testing and scaling your programs. Even if you're in sales and you're using sales technologies and you have your SDR or BDR teams, maybe they report to you and they're sending emails, test those. see what's working or what isn't. I mean, that's a very important thing. That touch point is so important. Number four, make sure if you're in marketing, you are delivering the right leads to sales. And this is important. You can do this through, you know, good scoring models. If you're using nurturing, and again, if you're using marketing automation, that's possible. So that way your sales team are getting those ripe oranges. They're not getting the seeds or the trees without fruit. And then lastly, we touched on, you know, make sure that you measure. And this is so important. You need to know as a marketer what's working and what's not so you can course correct in real time. And then your sales team and your entire, honestly, your entire revenue team is successful because it's again, this is a team sport. Both marketing and sales have to be all in to have this be successful. So I'm going to conclude with today's presentation. If you have comments or thoughts, please feel free to, you know, send me something on LinkedIn. I have my Twitter handle here, at Heidi Bullock. Also, the hashtag for this event for today is #InsideSales. Thanks, and happy selling, everyone.